elite of the Templars are ready, Herald. Be certain you are prepared for the assault on the breach. We cannot know how you will be affected.
Templars!
Focus past the Herald. Let her will draw from you.
Solas confirms the heavens are scarred but calm. The breach is sealed. We've reports of lingering rifts, and many questions remain. But this was a victory. Word of your heroism has spread.
You know how many were involved. Luck put me at the center.
A strange kind of luck. I'm not sure if we need more or less. But you're right. This was a victory of Alliance. One of the few in recent memory. With the breach closed, that Alliance will need new focus.
Forces approaching! To arms!
We must get to the gates.
Work was too easy.
They're afraid. Something's coming.
Always something. Important. Go protect us.
Cullen?
One watch guard reporting. It's a massive force, the bulk over the mountain.
Under what banner?
None.
None?
If someone could open this, I'd appreciate it.
I'm here to warn you.
Fashionably late, I'm afraid.
Might exhausted. Don't mind me. My name is Dorian Parvus, and I bring grave news from Redcliffe. An army of rebel mages right behind me. They are under the command of the Venatori, in service to something called the Elder One. The woman is Calpurnia. She commands the Venatori. That, the Elder One. They were already marching on Haven. I risked my life to get here first.
Cullen, give me a plan.
Haven is no
anything.
Fortress. If we are to withstand this monster, we must control the battle. Get out there and hit that force. Use everything you can.
Soldiers, gather the villagers. Fortify and watch for advanced forces. Inquisition, with the Herald, for your life, for all of us!
Thank you.
firing.
And it wants to break us!
Everyone to the gates!
Move it! Move it! Get everyone back to the chantry! It's the only building that might hold against that beast!
At this point, just make them work for it.
The village of the dead who don't... Unless you help.
Back here.
Hear that?
Now. What now? Out of time. Let me out of here.
Someone hurts.
Get it off. It's coming down.
Someone hurts.
Harold, what's happening? Baker, thank you. Thank you.
Our lady is with you, Harold. Thank you.
Hear that?
Are saved to die later. We should follow.
going. The Chantry is your shelter.
A brave man. He stood against a Venatori.
Briefly, I am no Templar.
Herald, our position is not good. That dragon stole back any time you might have earned us. There has been no communication, no demands. Only advance after advance.
There was no bargaining with the mages either. This Elder One takes what it wants. From what I gathered in Redcliffe, it marched all of this way to take your herald.
I don't care what he wants. How do I stop him?
Trust me, that is not information I would keep to myself. And such a promising start with the landslide. If only trebuchets remained an option.
They are, if we turn the last of them to the mountains above us.
We're overrun. To hit the enemy, we'd bury Haven.
This is not survivable now. The only choice left is how spitefully we end this.
Well, that's not acceptable. I didn't race here only to have you drop rocks on my head.
Should we submit? Let him kill us?
Dying is typically a last resort, not first. For a Templar, you think like a blood mage.
There is a path. You wouldn't know it was there unless you'd made the summer pilgrimage, as I have. The people can escape. She must have shown me. Andraste must have shown me so I could tell you.
What are you on about, Roderick?
It was whim that I walked the path. I did not mean to start. It was overgrown. Now, with so many in the Conclave dead, to be the only one who remembers... I don't know, Herald. If this simple memory can save us, this could be more than mere accident. You could be more.
What about it, Cullen? Will it work?
Possibly. If he shows us the path. But what of your escape?
Perhaps you can surprise the Elder One.
Inquisition! Follow Chancellor Roderick through the Chantry. Move!
Herald, if you are meant for this, if the Inquisition is meant for this, I pray for you.
They'll load the trebuchets. Keep the Elder One's attention until we're above the tree line.
If we are to have a chance, if you are to have a chance, let that thing hear you.
I know it's how to get an asshole's attention.
Ready!
must be aimed. Quickly!
Ready?
Move! Now!
Pretender, you toy with forces beyond your ken no more.
Whatever you are, I'm not afraid.
Words mortals often hurl at the darkness. Once they were mine, they are always lies. Know me. Know what you have pretended to be. Exalt the Elder One. The will that is Corypheus. You will kneel.
You'll get nothing out of me!
You will resist. You will always resist. It matters not. I am here for the anchor. The process of removing it begins now. It is your fault, Herald. You interrupted a ritual years in the planning, and instead of dying, you stole it. I do not know how you survived, but what marks you as touched, what you flail at rifts, I crafted to assault the very heavens. And you used the anchor to undo my work. The gall. Mortals have always cried thus. Praise me, for I would end the silence that answers. I once breached the Fade in the name of another to serve the old gods of the Empire in person. I found only chaos and corruption, dead whispers. For 1,000 years I was confused, no more. I have gathered the will to return under no name but my own, to champion Wither Tevinter and correct this blighted world. Beg that I succeed, for I have seen the throne of the gods, and it was empty. The anchor is permanent. You have spoilt it with your stumbling. So be it. I will begin again. Find another way to give this world the nation and God it requires. I will not suffer even an unknowing rival. You must die.
You expect me to fight, but that's not why I kept you talking. Enjoy your victory. Here's your prize! embers. Recent?
It's her!
Thank the Maker!
What would you have me tell them? This isn't what we asked them to do.
We cannot simply ignore this. We must find a way.
And who put you in charge? We need a consensus or we have nothing.
Please, we must use reason. Without the infrastructure of the Inquisition, we're hobbled.
It can't come from nowhere.
She didn't say it could.
Enough! This is getting us nowhere.
Well, we're agreed on that much.
Shh. You need rest. They've been at it for hours. They have that luxury, thanks to you. The enemy could not follow, and with time to doubt, we turn to blame. Infighting may threaten as much as this Corypheus.
Do we know where Corypheus and his forces are?
We are not sure where we are. Which may be why, despite the numbers he still commands, there is no sign of him. That, or you are believed dead. Or without Haven, we are thought helpless. Or he girds for another attack. I cannot claim to know the mind of that creature, only his effect on us.
If they're arguing about what we do next, I need to be there.
Another heated voice won't help. Even yours. Perhaps especially yours. Our leaders struggle because of what we survivors witnessed. We saw our defender stand and fall. And now we have seen her return. The more the enemy is beyond us, the more miraculous your actions appear. And the more our trials seem ordained. That is hard to accept, no? What we have been called to endure. What we perhaps must come to believe.
I escaped the avalanche. Barely, perhaps, but I didn't die.
Of course. And the dead cannot return from across the veil. But the people know what they saw. Or perhaps what they needed to see. The Maker works both in the moment and in how it is remembered. Can we truly know the heavens are not with us?
You saw Corypheus. What do you think of his claims of assaulting the heavens?
Scripture says magisters, Tevinter servants of false old gods, entered the Fade to reach the Golden City, seat of the Maker. For their crime, they were cast out as darkspawn. Their hubris is why we suffer blight, and why the Maker turned from us. If such is the claim of this Corypheus, he is a monster beyond imagining. All mankind continues to suffer for that sin. If even a shred of it is true, all the more reason Andraste would choose someone to rise against him.
All of this happened because of fanatics and arguments about the next world. It's time we start believing in this one.
path is dark, look to the sky, for one day soon the dawn will come. The shepherd's lost, and his home is far. Keep to the stars, the dawn will come. The night is long,
and the path is dark.
Look to the sky. It's all one world, Herald. All that changes is our place in it.
A word. The humans have not raised one of our people so high for ages beyond counting. Her faith is hard won, Lethaline, worthy of pride, save one detail. The threat Corypheus wields, the orb he carried, it is ours. Corypheus used the orb to open the breach. Unlocking it must have caused the explosion that destroyed the Conclave. We must find out how he survived, and we must prepare for their reaction when they learn the orb is of our people.
All right. What is it, and how do you know about it?
Such things were foci, said to channel power from our gods. Some were dedicated to specific members of our pantheon. All that remains are references in ruins, and faint visions of memory in the fade, echoes of a dead empire. But however Corypheus came to it, the orb is elven, and with it, he threatens the heart of human faith.
Their blame won't matter if we can't get out of this wilderness.
That is the immediate problem. And it offers a solution that may secure your place in their hearts. You saved them at Haven. Perhaps you can again. By attacking the Inquisition, Corypheus has changed it. Changed you. Scout to the north. Be their guide. There is a place that waits for a force to hold it. There is a place where the Inquisition can build, grow.
They arrive daily from every settlement in the region. Skyhold is becoming a pilgrimage. If word has reached these people, it will have reached the Elder One. We have the walls and numbers to put up a fight here, but this threat is far beyond the war we anticipated. But we now know what allowed you to stand against Corypheus. What drew him to you?
He came for this, and now it's useless to him, so he wants me dead. That's it.
The anchor has power, but it's not why you're still standing here. Your decisions let us heal the sky. Your determination brought us out of Haven. You are the creature's rival because of what you did. And we know it. All of us. The Inquisition requires a leader. The one who has already been leading it.
You're offering this to an elf? Are you quite sure you know what you're doing?
I would be terrified handing this power to anyone, but I believe it is the only way. They'll follow you. To them, being an elf shows how far you've risen, how it must have been by Andraste's hand. What it means to you, how you lead us, that is for you alone to determine.
This isn't about a greater message. We have an enemy, and we have to stand together. We'll do what is right. The Inquisition will fight for all of us.
Wherever you lead us.
Have our people been told?
They have. And soon, the world.
Commander, will they follow?
Inquisition, will you follow? Will you fight? Will we triumph? Your leader, your herald, your inquisitor!
So this is where it begins.
It began in the courtyard. This is where we turned that promise into action.
But what do we do? We know nothing about this Corypheus except that he wanted your mark.
Corypheus wants to restore Tevinter. Is this a prelude to war with the Imperium?
I get the feeling we're dealing with extremists, not the vanguard of a true invasion.
Tevinter is not the Imperium of 1,000 years ago. What Corypheus yearns to restore no longer exists.
Though they would shed no tears if the South fell to chaos, I'm certain.
Corypheus said he wanted to enter the Black City, that this would make him a god.
He is willing to tear this world apart to reach the next. It won't matter if he's wrong.
What if he's not wrong? If he finds some other way into the Fade?
Then he gains the power he seeks, or unleashes catastrophe on us all.
Could his dragon really be an archdemon? What would that mean?
It would mean the beginning of another blight.
We've seen no darkspawn other than Corypheus himself. Perhaps it's not an archdemon at all, but something different?
Whatever it is, it's dangerous. Commanding such a creature gives Corypheus an advantage we can't ignore.
Someone out there must know something about Corypheus.
Unless they saw him on the field, most will not believe he even exists.
We do have one advantage. We know what Corypheus intends to do next. When you were at Therrenfall, you uncovered a plot to kill Empress Selene.
Imagine the chaos her death would cause. With his army.
An army he's growing. The Envy Demon gloated about a massive force of demons.
Corypheus could conquer the entire south of Thedas, god or no god.
I'd feel better if we knew more about what we were dealing with.
I know someone who can help with that. Everyone acting all inspirational jogged my memory, so I sent a message to an old friend. She's crossed paths with Corypheus before and may know more about what he's doing. She can help.
I'm always looking for new allies. Introduce me.
Parading around might cause a fuss. It's better for you to meet privately, on the battlements. Trust me, it's complicated.
Well, then, we stand ready to move on both of these concerns.
On your order, Inquisitor.
I know one thing. If Varric has brought who I think he has, Cassandra is going to kill him.
This is the Inquisition. A dusty old ruin filled with battered soldiers.
If you shut your mouth and opened your eyes, you'd see that the Inquisition is our one